Hello! Today I've got another challenging nail art for you. At least it was a challenge to me. It's pretty much a fantasy team through keyholes. So let's get started. First off, I use this Essence nail polish called Love's Recipe, which actually reminds me more of stone than of love, actually. But it's pretty suitable for this look. And then I also used my Fortune Cookie by Essence, which is, as you can see, a gold glitter nail polish. And I also use the Catrice Gel-like 2-in-1 base and top coat as usual as a top coat. And then for acrylic paint, I used acrylic paint. Yeah. Pretty much, I stuffed a whole bunch of colors on a piece of paper because I had no idea what colors I wanted to use. So, yeah. Just pick as many as you want and, you know, you'll always have enough. And I also used this detail brush, which I got in a set of either eBay or Born Pretty Store. It was very cheap at any rate. Then I also used these rhinestones, which came from Born Pretty Store. I used the sort of teardrop, water drop ones in a gold shade. And I also used a rhinestone picker. This is optional. You don't necessarily need one. But I find it easy to use. And yeah, what I started out with is painting the keyhole shape, which is actually quite surprisingly difficult for some reason. I'm not good at making circles. And the top part of, you know, an old-fashioned keyhole is of course a circle, so yeah. And actually got this idea when I did a keyhole nail art, like, I think a few weeks ago. I'm not sure how long it was ago. Time flies. But yeah, I did a keyhole nail art, and there the focus was really on the keyhole itself, like an old ornamental medieval keyhole. But then I thought I could actually do a keyhole nail art, but then actually focus on what could be seen through a set keyhole. So yeah, I decided to do a fantasy world behind the keyhole. And fantasy to me is unicorns, so I decided to start out with the unicorn here. I think the trick with doing very tiny things on nails is actually to not try to go for too much detail. Just go for the basic shape, just a recognizable shape, and then add as many detail as you feel comfortable with. You know, but don't try to make it recognizable only through detail. Because nails are very, very tiny. Actually, I noticed while editing this that my nail as I have it can actually fit about 6 times in my nail as it's seen on the screen right now. So, you know, it always looks easier on screen because your nails will look bigger on screen than they do in real life. So, yeah. That's why I don't go for too much detail because that would fail. And then I also added a little sun there in the corner. Apparently it's a punker unicorn, by the way, with like a pink mohawk. Because why not? I like pink. And then I did the background. You could also do the background first and let it dry and then add the detail on the foreground. However, I'm far too hasty to let things dry properly, as usually. So that's why I started with the foreground and then did the background. Because if I would do the background first, not let it dry, and then try to do a white unicorn, the unicorn would just get a pale green because, you know, it would mix together. The mixing together thing can actually be quite useful because that's what I did with the mountains here. It's pretty much my go-to method whenever I want to, you know, mix anything. I just, you know, while both of the colors are still wet, I just sort of dab the brush into it. So they sort of mingle together and form a ombre effect. So the woodlands actually, you know, move on into the mountains. Rather than just suddenly stop. And I did the same thing with the snow on the mountaintops. And if you still have too much product on the brush, just wipe it off and then go dab into it. And then I added the sky, obviously. And also, one plus of this also is that you can just fix mistakes with the next color. For example, I wanted the mountains to be a bit more pointy than they ended up being, so I just used the color of the sky to fix up the mountains. Very nice and easy. And I did the same thing actually with the horn of the unicorn. Just go back and forth between colors until everything looks like you want it to look. And I then moved on to a gold shade. Well, sort of gold, it's not shiny obviously. But just sort of a gold tone acrylic paint and just lined the keyhole. Because the nail polish I'm going to use, the glittery gold one, isn't actually opaque. For example, if you're using a opaque nail polish, like a gold metallic nail polish or a gold glitter nail polish, that's actually going to completely cover whatever you put it on, then you don't need to do this. However, mine is just glitter in a clear base. So I needed the color behind it, so it wouldn't actually be see-through in the end. And then on the other nail, I actually started out with the gold shade, which I could have done on the former nail as well. So, you know, if you want to do this as well, just start out with the gold. It's easier. But yeah, on this nail, I decided to do a simpler design, mostly because... Well, for two reasons. One of the reasons being that I didn't think I would manage to do a second landscape without screwing it up. And second, because the only other fantasy thing I could think of was dragons, and I actually completely suck at painting dragons, so I didn't want to risk it. So what I decided to do instead is just paint what the unicorn would see if it would look through the keyhole that's, you know, being used to look at him at this point. Which is obviously an eyeball of the person looking at him. Yep. So I decided to just paint a big blue eye with some green stripes in it. You could also do a brown eye with like orange stripes in it. But I really feel like the two colors in the iris actually do make it look more like an eye and less like a random colored ball. And yeah, just mix it together a little with the whole dabbing method. And then also added a pupil. Again, I'm too hasty to wait for the paint to dry, so it mixed together a little bit. But the plus with black is, as long as you apply enough, it will cover anything. So yeah, just apply the whole thick blob of black paint. And then I also did a little bit of highlight, because obviously acrylic paint dries matte, and I did still want the eye to look lively once it's dry. And then I just did a little bit of a lash line all the way in the top. For some reason I managed to do so out of focus, but it's pretty much just a straight line across the top of the eye, like between the eye and the keel. And then the acrylic paint had dried and it was time for the glitter nail polish. So I just, yeah, this is like literally one of the easiest steps in the entire nail art. I just traced where I already put the gold acrylic paint and just made it glittery. I suppose actually that a metallic nail polish would look more natural for a keyhole, but I don't know. I just really love glitter, and I think glitter is very suitable for fantasy, and I just wanted glitter. And then on the middle nail, I did those two paintings on my ring finger nail and my index finger nail. So on my middle finger nail, I did three rhinestones, yeah. Counting is difficult. I did three rhinestones. And like I said at the beginning, the rhinestone picker is optional. You can also use a toothpick or a dotting tool, if you do have a dotting tool, or a hairpin. And just dip it lightly in the top coat, and then you can also use that to grab the rhinestones. You know, just use whatever you have, it'll work. And yeah. Then, once all of that is dry, it's time to add top coat. I use a very thick blob of top coat and really make sure to not drag it over the painting more often than necessary, because I don't want to drag it out. And then here is the final result. I really enjoy doing this, mostly because it was actually a challenge to me. I do actually want to try and find a smaller nail art brush though. Because I feel like it would be easier, you know, to do tiny details if I actually had a tinier brush. If any of you has any tips on what very tiny nail art brushes you like to use, I'd love to hear it. For now, I really hope you enjoyed watching this. If you did, please click the like button. And you can also always subscribe to my channel if you'd like. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time. Bye!